Okay, welcome to part two of making your own bot for day trading. This is going to be just me rambling on, problem solving, going back and forth between the strategy tester, the meta editor, the language coding editor for MetaTrader 4, as well as ChatGPT. So I'm going to go in and start working on this. I'm going to start fresh, all new. And I will discuss everything that I've typed into ChatGPT. And this video is just going to be sped up in between times when I am not talking. So first, you want to prompt your ChatGPT and ask if you are familiar with MetaTrader 4 and the coding language to make an EA trading bot. It's basically priming ChatGPT to know where to start when you're asking it questions. Okay, so I told ChatGPT I would like to make a trading bot. Here are the rules for entry of a trade. The bot will automatically calculate the account balance and enter in trades based on the account balance and risk 1% of account balance per trade. In the settings of the bot, I want to have the ability to change the hours in which the bot is trading. By default, I wanted to trade from 8 a.m. to 1400 server time, so 8 a.m. to 2 p.m. This will all be on the 5-minute time frame chart. For a buy trade, if a bullish engulfing candle prints that engulfs the previous two candles, then the bot will enter a buy order at the current market price. The trade will only happen once the 5-minute candle is closed. For a sell trade, if a bearish engulfing candle prints that engulfs the previous two candles, the bot will enter a sell trade at the current market price. The trade will only happen once the 5-minute candle is closed. The stop loss for a buy will be the lowest price of the entry candle. The stop loss for a sell will be the highest price of the entry candle. The take profit will be 2 times the stop loss for both buy and sell trades. So now I just click send message, copy the code, and we're going to create a new thing, expert advisor, rename it to YouTube test, on chart event, on tester, select all of that, paste that in, and compile. So we got 3 errors and 2 warnings. Copy that all and give it to ChatGPT to fix and say, please fix these errors and warnings. So delete the old code, paste in the new one, compile it again, still getting 3 errors, but no more warnings. Copy all of that, paste it into ChatGPT, compile again, still 3 errors. And you just got to keep doing this back and forth constantly, kind of a pain. We got 0 errors. That is very nice. When you save as, you have to do it in the MQL4 folder and then in the experts. Once you refresh your MetaTrader, it'll be here in your strategy tester. All right, so the bot did not enter in any trades, so we need to ask ChatGPT why. So I just wrote in, the bot is not entering any trades. Can you please figure out why? Also, I'd like this bot to trade on NAS100 on the 5-minute time frame. I didn't clarify that before, but maybe it might help. So copy that code. No errors when I was compiling. Still not entering trades. So I need to talk to ChatGPT and maybe help it define what an engulfing candle is. So I told ChatGPT I'm going to define what I mean by engulfing candles and you can add it to the code. The total calculations are for 3 candles and based on the high open low close of the candles. Bullish engulfing candle, the first 5-minute candle is bearish, second candle is also bearish, and the third candle's closing price is higher than the highest price of the first candle in the series of 3 candles, opposite for bearish engulfing. We got 6 warnings, so I will copy these errors and give it back to ChatGPT. Okay, it's still not working, so back to the drawing board with ChatGPT. I will let you know what I tell it to do. Okay, so I've started completely over. I asked it if it knows what MetaTrader 4 is, primed it for its current task, and told it I would like to make a bot. This is on NAS100 on the 5-minute chart. The rules for a buy entry, if a bullish engulfing 5-minute candle closes, enter a buy trade at the current ask price. Lot size for the trade will be 0.01. Rules for sell entry are the exact opposite. Stop loss for either buy or sell trades will be 1,000 ticks. Take profit for both buy or sell will be 2,000 ticks. Stop loss, take profit, and lot size will be adjustable in settings. Again, keep giving ChatGPT all of the errors to fix. Sometimes it'll only give you the corrections, so you have to ask it for the entire code because I don't know how to adjust it or edit it or where to put it. All right, so after 20 times back and forth with all the errors, we finally have something that functions, so let's test it out. I'm going to rename it because it's a completely different bot. Okay, so after a gajillion back and forths, we finally have a bot that enters trades and actually does something. It's absolutely horrible for right now. We started with an initial deposit of $100,000 and it is down $53,649. Overall, it has had 74 consecutive losses. It has won 27% of the short positions and 30% of the long positions. So now what we can do is go into the settings in the expert properties of the EA and adjust the stop loss, take profit, as well as the lot. Actually, let's leave the lot size. Let's not adjust that. Let's just do the stop loss and take profit. So we're going to start with a stop loss because 1,000 ticks is essentially 10 points on NAS. So let's start with 500, do steps of 100. So every increment is 1 point. So $1 movement in NAS. And stop loss, maybe we can go up to 15 points. I don't want to do anything more than that. Take profit, we can start at 10 points, steps 100, so 1 point, and let's do 5,000 ticks, which is 50 points. Now just click OK, click the optimization icon right here, and then make sure this model is set at opening prices only. We don't need to do every tick because our bot trades on the closing prices, so it doesn't need every tick. And then you just click start. So a bunch of passes were done during optimization and they've been discarded as insignificant, which means there's no benefit in adjusting the stop loss and the take profit of the bot. But we have something that works now, so all we have to do is add code using ChatGPT to give it more parameters for trading. For example, the trading hours, whether it's 8 a.m. to 11 a.m., or whether price is above or below a specific moving average. So because I've been doing this for an hour and a half, what I'm going to do is end this episode here and do episode 3 on Monday. I'm going to add some extra parameters over the weekend, and I'm going to let you know how the bot worked out.